Welcome to our math adventure. In this video, we will prove the seemingly paradoxical statement 1 equals to 0.9 repeating, examining it at two different difficulty levels. The first proof is simple, with a basic understanding of decimal number and arithmetic, even kids can tackle it. Step 1, multiply 0.9 recurring by 10, which shifts the decimal point one place to the right. So 0.9 repeating becomes 9.9 repeating. Then split the right-hand side into integer and fractional parts. Next, subtract 0.9 repeating from both sides. Finally, dividing both sides by 9 yields the desired equality. Skeptics might question the validity of these operations, especially when the seemingly special number like 0.9 repeating is involved. They may ask why you can subtract and divide both sides by the same number and still preserve equality. The quick answer? We treat 0.9 repeating here as a real number, just like any other real numbers, such as 0, pi, or minus 2.4. Therefore, any operation valid for real numbers applies here. But if you're still not convinced, no worries, let me introduce you to a more advanced and fascinating proof used by mathematicians. Our confusion with this problem stems from understanding the number 0.9 recurring. What does it mean to have infinitely many digits after a decimal point? What is infinity? At this point, you might even wonder what exactly is real number. These questions once troubled mathematicians too, but fortunately, they found the answers for us. You will learn answers to all these questions in a calculus analysis class, delve into rigorous definition of real number. You will also discover that 0.9 repeating can be expressed as a limit of this expression as n approaches infinity. This expression here is just a compact way of writing 0.9 with n nines after the decimal point. So when this n gets larger and goes to infinity, it exactly represents 0.9 with infinitely many digit nines after the decimal point. Therefore, to show 0.9 recurring equals to 1, we need to show that this limit also equals to 1, which means that as n approaches infinity, this expression approaches 1. So how do mathematicians prove this claim? Well, they start by formulating things unambiguously. Mathematicians work through abstraction, describing things using definitions or axioms, and proving theorems and propositions from them. Definitions or axioms serve as a foundation of mathematics, so they will first ask questions like, what does approaches mean mathematically? How do we describe infinity? While you might intuitively understand what an approaches infinity means, expressing this precisely can be challenging. Here is a formal definition of limit above in mathematical notation. It states that for any number epsilon greater than 0, there always exists some natural number capital N correspondingly, such that for any n greater than this capital N, the difference between this expression and 1 is less than epsilon. This is how mathematicians define what, when n approaches infinity, some expression approaches 1 means mathematically. If you find this definition overwhelming, you're not alone. Even Sir Isaac Newton did not have a clear grasp on the definition of limit despite discovering it. It was years after Newton before mathematician Karl Weierstrass finally developed this indisputable notion of limit, usually referred to as the epsilon-delta formulation. This allows mathematicians to elegantly resolve disputes like 1 equals to 0.9 repeating. While it's a useful tool, mastering it takes time. But if you master this definition, you will have a deeper insight than Newton had on this subject. Now, let's dive into the proof based solely on the introduced definition of the limit. So, follow the definition, we need to show that for any number epsilon greater than 0, we can find a natural number capital N correspondingly, such that for any natural number n greater or equal to this capital N, the absolute difference between 1 and this expression here is less than epsilon. First, let's rewrite what's inside the absolute value symbol. As we showed earlier, this expression is exactly 0.9 with n nines after the decimal point. Therefore, the absolute value of 1 minus it is equal to 1 over 10 to the n. This inequality is equivalent to this inequality after we take logarithm of base 10 on both sides. Then, we obtain that the original inequality holds if and only if n is greater than log of epsilon. This means that if we take capital N to be the smallest natural number greater or equal to log epsilon, then for any n greater or equal to capital N, the original inequality must hold. Since epsilon is arbitrary, and for any such arbitrary epsilon, we are able to find a corresponding capital N by this procedure, such that whenever n is greater or equal to this capital N, the absolute difference between this expression and 1 is less than epsilon. By definition, this limit is equal to 1. Additionally, we know that this limit is exactly 0.9 repeating. Therefore, we have just proved 1 equals 0.9 repeating using only the definition of a limit. Once you grasp that 1 equals 0.9 repeating, congratulations! You have unlocked a fascinating truth that your elementary school teacher likely didn't tell you. There is an infinite number of numbers with two different decimal representations. This means that you can write many numbers in two distinct ways, just like we demonstrated with the number 1. Cool, right? Here are some more examples. The reasoning and proof behind all of them are exactly similar to the proof of 1 equals to 0.9 repeating. With a bit more effort, I believe you could prove them yourself at this point. Thanks for watching, I'll see you in the next one.